close. So his live ranking's at 131. Oh, that was long. Oh, gosh. Both guys looking at Izzy in the chair, saying that that missed by well long is right. Both guys had stopped playing. Happens, though. But it does create an opening here for Mr. Mmoh at 15:30. Will say is Mike didn't even argue the original no call at all.
Wow.
So it's a quick
match so far. Been pretty rough so far.
That is over towards Brad Taylor, our challenger supervisor. That's a big one. Mmoh didn't argue when there was no call coming from the last person. That's the way I'm going to read it. That was a psychotic laugh. That is actually a moment shared between the two competitors there. Had a couple here on the day. Literally four or five that have gone against Eubanks and been in better positions for Michael Mmoh. There's been a lot that's gone on here that's not exactly tennis related here of late. It's important for Mmoh just to kind of make sure the ship is righted here. Stay focused on the task at hand. Take care of things on his serve. Hope that maybe there will be a little drop off at some point from Eubanks. I didn't even notice.
I will call him.
That was good. I gotta be honest, I didn't even notice at the time.
I believe you, and I'm sorry if I made a mistake.
Brad Taylor has been called to the court.
I believe you guys. So, did I make the
court? Oh, that's not even Brad Taylor. As I was saying, okay, now Brad Taylor is making his way to the court, and I think both players are going to express their displeasure. There's not a lot that's going to be done, but this is a necessary moment considering both guys have kind of lost the plot in terms of.
I made a scoring error, and I'm sorry, he is getting off.
Both guys are just making their complaints heard about the calls, about the scoring error, and I. So what I was going to say actually just a minute ago, the fact that it is tough when you're in these moments, especially newer chairs, right? When you kind of get lost in with Eubanks being as demonstrative as he is, you wonder if you maybe made a mistake earlier. And sometimes it can compound itself, right? The task at hand right now is a very mental one for both players to just, again, lock back in. It's Eubanks right now talking to Ron Rolofse, his coach. This is all towards Brad Taylor, our supervisor, who has been watching this here for the last hour. And Chris is going to get potentially engaged in this conversation as well. So both guys have been asking now. Chris was asking this earlier. Mike is asking it now about calling through the net. And I can say that I've done this for 9 years. I don't remember a match where both players have been this unhappy through a set like this. This is a completely new situation for me. That was an under. Oh my gosh. Well, Christopher Eubanks into his second straight final. Yes, that was indeed Michael Mmoh destroying a racket, understandably. This is a tough one. Yeah, these two competitors, a lot of respect between the two of them. And yeah, understandably, a really frosty moment there. Yeah, it was a tough watch here today.